everybody. My name is Mitch Metzger, serving with youth with a mission here in the Philippines. And I'm sitting here in an average Filipino jeepney, a real symbol of ingenuity of the Filipino craftiness. And I'll tell you, there's thousands of these all over the city, and you'll get a glimpse of more later on as we go through an average Friday in the life of Mitch and Liberty Metzger. And just stick around, okay? Follow us through this day, okay? It'll be a great time, especially our evangelism later tonight.
The Philippines, about the same length of California with its many beaches and fishing waters, combined with thousands of acres of farmland, make the Philippines highly agricultural in nature anywhere outside of the city. 70 million people, mostly Roman Catholic, Protestant, and Muslims, live throughout the 7,000 islands.
Jesus Christ on that jeepney. You know, the Philippines is over 87% Roman Catholic, so it's not uncommon to see lots of religious types of things on cars, on houses, on jeepneys such as this, slogans, etc. That's very common. These are the king of the road. They love to put their pride into their vehicles, their family names, and look at the colors that they use. All these fluorescent colors, fluorescent stripings and pinstripings, etc. It's just really the king of the road. A lot of the city wants to phase out the jeepney, but I really doubt if it's ever going to happen. They just really want to hang. It's really a tradition, you know. But I'll tell you, look at these people getting in these vehicles. Some of them are going to be sitting there for an hour and a half, and then when they go home, another hour, hour and a half. So some of these people are going to be sitting in traffic for 3 hours today. 3 hours. And it's really sad, because the majority of your energy is wasted just sitting and waiting in traffic. But that's the mega city in the world. The world is coming to cities all over the place. I mean, every city is growing. Manila's growing 5,000 people every day, just every day, another 5,000 people. So, but we love the city, and that's why we're here. And I don't mind sitting in traffic if it's where God called us to be. So there you go, traffic in Manila. All right, let's take a ride maybe, huh? Hey.
How do we get around? Well, we've got tricycles for trips just down the street, and of course the jeepney once again with its color, pride, and fancy horns. Listen to this. We've got taxi services and many buses for trips just across the city or to nearby cities. And of course, boats of all different sizes for island-to-island travel throughout the country as well. And of course, airplanes for international and domestic flights serving most of our major cities throughout the Philippines and throughout the world.
Okay, here we are at Jesus Our Hope International's Assemblies. This is an Assembly of God church here in Cubao, our home. And it's about 5 minutes from our apartment. And this is where Liberty and I come, my wife. And it used to be a big, big house, but they expanded it and converted it into a church. It's about 15 years old, and it holds about 800 people. Let's go take a look, okay? It's a little Sunday school area right here for kids, you know, a little children's area. Very simple, offices are upstairs. You're all late for the camera, huh? And here's some ladies making flowers for a wedding, I think. A wedding, right? A wedding later on? Jesus Our Hope in it. Look at all that's a very nice altar up there. Jesus. Here for extra overflow of people, and they've got about three services here every Sunday. I believe it's five services now every Sunday, because there's just lots of people wanting to come. So that's it. Jesus Our Hope International Assemblies.
Bye.
Bye. Thanks, ladies.
No, the Philippines is not all beaches and farmland. This McDonald's is just one of over 200 in the country, and this 7-Eleven is just near our home. Many other familiar businesses are opening up throughout the country as well.
Well, here we are, not far from my house, about 3 minutes away only, walking distances. JRS and DHL, these are like similar to UPS postage systems in America. Very like 1 day, 2 day, 3 day service. Very convenient to have. And right beside it is a jail and the police station. See all the blue bicycles? Those are little mobile bicycles that these little policemen ride around. And many times they don't know how to ride the bicycles, though, I've noticed, but they've got a good heart. And way on the end is the post office. It's not open right now, but it's just right around the corner. I'll show you where my box is, just in case you want to send me a letter, huh? Okay, come on. Yeah. This is the post office, very convenient and very efficient, no problems with theft or anything like that, and your normal post office, okay? Come on down this way, I'll show you our box, okay? I'll tell you, during the day, there's long lines all the way up to this line, just massive people, and it's better to have your own stamps, I'll tell you, unless you want to stand in line for about an hour. It's gonna be a sunny day today, looks like. Let's see if there's anything exciting today. Oh, yeah. Well, we've got a few things from some friends back home. Thanks for that. All right. Well, this is the fire station. Usually there's about four trucks here, but this serves the whole area. And I'm not sure how efficient they'll really be if you've got a real fire, because the traffic and the one-ways and everything make it pretty hard for them to get around. But I don't know, you're pretty much in the Lord's hands if you get a house, if your house is on fire around here, that's for sure. But nevertheless, they're here on working 24 hours a day, ready to go. And that's our fire station. Yeah, this is the Fiesta Carnival. Take a look here. This is where many, many people will come, especially in the evenings. It's morning now, so it's closed, but you know, Cubao is known for fun and entertainment, and lots of families like to come to this area just for eating and dining and kiddie rides, etc. And this is a common place. There's little scooters in there and go-karts and all kinds of snacks and food. It's called the Fiesta Carnival. It's a great place to come. We can't do evangelism in there, but it's a place where I come. I like the shooting gallery on the other end, and maybe I'll show you some scenes of that later, but that's the Fiesta Carnival. Take a look. A slow time because it's still before lunch and it's a work day. Most people work, but I'll tell you, in the evenings it's busy here. But there's a few people here at the shooting gallery. This is one of my favorite places to come. It's 10 pesos for I think 20 BBs, and it reminds me of some of my old Marine days. Kind of keeps the Marine fire burning. Let's go over here and I'll show you how to shoot this BB gun, huh? Okay, come on. So this is 10 pesos, that's about a quarter in America, 25 cents. And he's gonna give me some BBs here, and it's pretty easy. You just put them in there, just like a normal BB gun, and you shoot whatever you want. And if you hit it, you'll hear a little bell sometimes. Oh, I missed my first shot. I missed my second shot. Maybe we should turn the camera off and just record the shots that I make. It
keeps the level on.
All right.
There is Apple.
All right.
This looks like it's not
fair. That should be excellent. Not the thing for others also because I don't see anybody riding it, but yeah, that's not for me. That Even Liberty gets sick on those things. I get dizzy just watching it. Y'all want to say hello to my friends here? All right, this is the place where I do all my business. They give me great service, great clear copies, cheap, wonderful crew.
This here is an FX, I don't know what you want to call it, FX Tamaral Jeepney almost. It's not a Jeepney, it's a Tamaral. I think it's foreign made. I'm not sure what country, but this is another form of transportation in the Philippines. For about 20 pesos, a quarter, or 15 cents, you can go really about 5 miles straight down this particular highway. And it fits about 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, about 9 people. And it's air conditioned, and it seems to be the upcoming form of transportation because of its comfort and people like aircon. I mean, it's hot here. It's like probably 87 degrees today. So, plenty here. Ito, bayad. There's dalawa. Bayad means here's my payment. Dalawa means two of us. So, unfortunately, no receipt. Sayang. Can't get my money back from Clinton. Gotta have a receipt for taxes, you know.
Real simple, nice, clean gym, and membership isn't much. Maybe about $20 a month, something like that, I think. So, here he is. He's here every day. He's one of the managers, and some guy that's using his. It's real quiet this morning. It's also summer, so then. Great, so that's the place. Okay, we'll see ya. The grocery store that Liberty and I shop at all the time has everything we need. Granola's my favorite, way over in the corner there. Skim milk and lots of juices, apple juice and orange juice and grape juice. So we've got all my favorite stuff I can find right here. So this is the place. All right. Here's some of the workers there. Pretty beautiful, huh? This is the public market. Normally, Liberty is the one to go. She can get the cheaper prices. It's best to go in the morning when all the food is fresh, since none of the foods are refrigerated or sheltered from outside elements or critters like this cat. It's actually in the morning that all the vendors stock their shelves and tables, whether it's garlic and onions or soybean products, or as you'll see on the left side, dried fish and fresh fish as well, and other seafoods like clams and crabs and lobsters and fresh chicken and sausage products that you'll see on the left side, and pork chops and other pork cuts on the right side. And for about $2 a pound, you can get beef steaks and beef cuts, as you'll see on the left.
This is Ate Marie. This is my suki. I always buy it for
watermelon, Filipino Tagalog word patwan, actually from Taiwan, although we do grow watermelon here in the Philippines. And a watermelon about this size is about $1.50 each. Not bad.
Come on in, okay, and I'll show you around, all right? Get my key out here. We got to lock our doors all the time because a lot of thieves around here. Okay, come on in, all right? I'll get the door for you.
The Metzgers. Mitch and Liberty right here, 17C. Why don't you go first, okay? And I'll show you around, all right? Sure, on this way. This is our living room, of course, or called sala in the Philippines. This is actually pull out when we get visitors. They can sleep here. And let me turn the light on. Here, this is my office area. Hope it's not too dark. But here's our my computer and fax machine and other office supplies and things. A scanner, which I use to make brochures and other things like that. And this is a Liberty sewing machine. Liberty likes to sew in her free time. And we got this for my sister Pam. Thanks, Pam, if you're watching, all right? And our kitchen area. Cooking area is quite simple. We don't have electric cooking possibility. But we use gas, change about once every 6 months, and not a lot of room for cutting and chopping vegetables, but it works. We're just a family of three, so it's pretty easy. And there's a small bathroom here, and complete with a shower facility. Look at it, check out the shower facility. This is our shower. Yeah, you just go like this and dump it over your head. Yeah, that's about the 99% of this country does it this way. But it's really the only practical way because it's so hot here. I mean, it's like 87, 90 degrees almost every day. And so nothing better than a nice cool shower. Matter of fact, there's no hot water. Majority of the homes, there is no hot water. It's just a cold water only. But here's our laundry area. We do all of our laundry. We used to do our laundry by hand. Can you imagine washing laundry by hand? For 10 years I did it that way, but I just don't have the energy anymore for doing it by hand. So we finally got ourselves a machine with a spinner on this side. And here's the spinner. It spins around and then we hang it all up. And I did about a week of laundry just yesterday. I mean, tons of laundry, but maybe about twice a week we'll do our laundry and hang it out here to dry, and it'll be done by noon. What else you want to see? You want to go upstairs? I think Liberty and Evangeline are watching TV. Let's go sneak up on them. Let's go sneak up on them, okay? Shh. Ooh, look at that, a mouse. Did you see that? Look at that. Mouse, there's his little hole. That's not uncommon. We get about 8 mice a month, but we got the sticky paper we put out, and they'll get on this paper and it's like glue. They can't move, you know, but I'll have to get him later. Here's our bathroom. There's Evangeline and Mommy taking a little nap. This is Evangeline's bed normally, but she's cheating today by sleeping on Daddy's bed. Are you sleeping on Daddy's bed? Naughty, naughty. Here's our guest room. Nice little simple room for guests. We used to get about 15 guests a month because we're so close to the transportation around town, but now probably realistically about 8 overnighters a month, and they like to stay here. We just recently got a TV about a year ago, and it's not cable though, we just are local channels only. And this is it, this is our guest room. So if any of you ever want to visit us in the Philippines, well, this is where you can stay free of charge. Look at this. Don't feel pressured or obligated to pay for your stay with us. Our hospitality is free. If you're a millionaire or relative of Bill Gates, this sign does not apply to you. Okay. So that's it. That's the tour of our home, okay? Let's go downstairs again, all right? We are mobilizing the body of Christ to reach all nations through organizing mission conferences throughout the Philippines, in which we bring hundreds of believers together for a few days to challenge them with God's heart for all nations through hearing dynamic speakers, attending specialized workshops, and joining short-term outreaches each summer. We also teach a world mission and evangelism seminars, and often a 1 or 5 day session, for churches, other YWAM training facilities, and other groups imparting awareness and vision of God's global movement and missions for greater praying, greater giving and going on the part of the individuals or the church group for both throughout the Philippines and abroad. We have been developing our own mission literature that is designed to stimulate mission awareness throughout the body of Christ in the Philippines, helping them to keep the call alive in their hearts. With over 10 titles completed so far on subjects such as, are 90% of our missionaries serving in the wrong places? What is an unreached people group? Street preaching in the Bible? The average church and the average Great Commission? And our yearly training schools and seminar guide all contribute to helping individuals to find, to catch, and to obey God's role for them in missions. Just recently, we volunteered to design and upload and maintain our first YWAM Philippines website. It's for the purpose of providing the necessary information to the global body of Christ via the internet. Information about our organization, its various bases and ministries, key teachings, pictures, and upcoming events, and other essential links with other partner organizations can all be found at our website. This includes the administrative management of our many letters we receive daily via electronic mail email. Often our Sundays are spent visiting different churches around Manila, stirring mission vision and awareness, teaching on some facet of missions, or simply sharing about YWAM in one way or another. Many young Christians will seek our counsel about finding their role in missions as well. Because of the rapid increase in Filipinos wanting to go into all nations for evangelism and church planting, especially throughout Asia, we compile and make available these lists of contacts in the various countries for them to effectively partner with others already serving there. Because good visual aids are essential to complement good teachers, we have been developing various mission sermonettes, colorful transparencies and illustrations, and scripts for mission dramas and other church mobilization essentials, and combining them in the form of a mobilization kit. This will help to equip other YWAMers and believers so that they might be ready always to challenge their home group, church group, Sunday school, or seminar attendance. We hope to finish this in the very near future. In the planning stage is a future school of mission mobilization, where we hope to further multiply ourselves and giftings into other workers. We also relate with many frontline Muslim ministries in order to serve them in various ways as well. Operation EDSA, 40 days straight of everyday evangelism, rain or shine. It's during this 40-day period each year that we preach the gospel of Jesus Christ along Metro Manila's busiest highway during the peak hours of traffic, in front of malls and restaurants, banks, bus stops, and movie theaters. Literally thousands will hear and be exposed to our witness during the peak rush hours. Often churches, youth groups, and other YWAMers will join us as we street preach to the masses in the open air. And 1999 will mark our second year of leading this campaign where we see fruit on a daily basis. During the school year, as a form of outreach, Liberty tutors a small group of 3 to 5 non-English speaking Filipino Muslims. Every summer is our big opportunity to train students through our numerous discipleship training weeks just outside of Metro Manila. The students will hear some of YWAM's best teachings, such as quiet time, hearing God's voice, intercession, clear conscience, worship, faithfulness, relationships, and evangelism and missions. Lots of fun, but designed more like a missions boot camp. The students will also be assigned daily work duties, such as bathroom cleanup, cooking, and harder manual labor for the guys. All students will receive an introduction to creative arts, drama, and dance to further equip them with the further tools for sharing the gospel through other mediums. Since 1996, we've graduated over 200 students during the summers, with many of them going on to take further training with YWAM. We're equipping them to learn to pray for all nations, tribes, and tongues, not merely just themselves and their circle of influence. And what is the result? Transformed lives, explosive with enthusiasm and vision beyond themselves, ready to take on the challenge of the nations. Hearts filled with joy and ashamed to go back to their schools, jobs, and the world. This is what we're doing in the Philippines. You know, Cubao, the part we're living in now, has often been known as a place of entertainment and family fun, and you know, there's carnivals and
many, many restaurants. There's lots of, banks and ATM machines and money availability and stores and clothing stores and shoe stores and, you know, all kinds of just ice cream places and places you can take your family. Tons of McDonald's is on every corner, it seems. And so the day, it's really quite a nice, it seems nice and, you know, great place to come. There's bookstores and school supply stores, and it's your average basic city with all of its conveniences. And but you know, at nighttime, it's like this place totally really transforms. It seems like once the store's all closed, the bar life opens up, and the movie theaters are blazing with their lights, and they start carrying out their marquees to exhibit their movies and things. You'll just see all kinds of darkness coming out. You'll see women, yes, but as you get farther into the evening, they're not good women. We have prostitution problems. Just down the street, there's probably over 100 prostitutes working in about 10 or 12 bars just down here. Some bars will have 30 or 40 girls in one bar. And so it's a whole, like a Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde thing. Turns into a Frankenstein at night. And that's why we want to be here. That's why we just really feel that we are to be here to be light and salt and to provide a witness. Many do ask this simple question, is why in the world do you want to go out there in the streets and do what you do? Aren't you afraid? Isn't it dangerous? Don't you think people will think you're crazy? And what's the use? They're not going to listen anyhow. But, you know, in the book of Psalms, chapter 10, verse 4, King David talked about how the wicked, the people that are not Christians, those that are not saved, those that don't know God, in their proud countenance, they will not seek after God. God is not even in their thoughts. They say in their heart, God's not even looking. And so I figure the majority of people out there, if they're not thinking about God, the thing that we can do as Christians is at least get them thinking about God. It's a step in the right direction.
Hey, magandang gabi sa iyong lahat. My uncle si Mitch. Apelido Metzger. Nakatira dito sa Philippines 10 taon na. And meron akong magandang information para sa iyo kung gusto mo nakinig. Alam mo ba, 87%, 87% of ang lahat ng mga sira ng pamilya dito sa Philippines galing sa San Miguel? Alam mo ba yan? It's not those that know the word, but those that obey the word that will have eternal life. Although I was going to church for 20 years, and although alam ko ang lahat ng mga utos ng Diyos, ang aking buhay ay hindi bago pa. Ang favoritong aktibidad para sa mga lalaki tuwing Biyernes ng gabi ay hindi pumasok sa Bible study. Sa disco, man! Buy one, you know, tumiting ang para sa chicks, you know, barkada, barkada. And I'm speaking para sa mga lalaki na yon. Ang hari ni bahay, ang hari ni familia, ay hindi babae. It's the mga lalaki. It's us, mga lalaki. We are the leaders of the home. Mga lalaki, you're in big trouble. Big trouble. You
reap what you sow, friend. You reap what you sow. And I'm telling you, Mangalalake, you're breaking the seventh commandment. And it's adultery. This is adultery. What is her body for you? Who's her body for? Her husband. I will give, listen, I will give 20 pesos to anybody that can tell me what true love is. Free money. Free money. I want a lalake, preferably. What is true love? I want to hear it from a love. What is true love? True or false? True or false? Is love a feeling?
Yes.
No! Oh. Love is not a feeling. No, that's not love. Love is not a feeling. Love is a commitment. Love is a commitment. Love is a commitment. If you love somebody, you will marry them. If you're not married, you're not committed. And if you're not committed, you're not loving. Because love is a commitment. Ulit again. If you're not married, you're not committed. And if you're not committed, you're not loving. Because love is a commitment. If you love your girlfriend, you'll marry her.
I could show you, I mean, almost daily, I could show you experiences I've had with, meeting people in the streets and seeing interesting things happen. I think of a guy I met about a couple months ago, and he was a homosexual, and he had just come out of this bar, and I was on the corner preaching, and he said, Mitch, he didn't know my name, he said, hey, I just came out of this, not bar, but I just came out of this hotel, and I, with my male lover, and my wife doesn't know about this alternate lifestyle of mine, and I really want help, I really want change. And all types of different things happen when we go out in the streets. And the
real man has self-control. A real man says no. A real man keeps his lips for a second and surreal. The kill of the wedding day. And my Dadaga, you listen to me. You're not going to hear this in the movie theater. You're not going to hear this on TV. You're not going to hear this on Ikulaga. You're not going to hear this on TGIS. Sex before marriage is wrong, and it's always wrong. Sex before marriage is breaking the seventh commandment of God. You want to be a macho man? You stay virgin until your wedding day. That's right. A real woman is a virgin on her wedding day. And a real man is a virgin on his wedding day. No double standards. You and all you want to do on Friday night is disco, Barcada, San Miguel, kicks, and movies. Did you know Ang Numero Uno movie this year was Shakespeare in Love? Did you? Did you hear that? The number one movie this year was Shakespeare in Love. Did you know that? Shakespeare in Love is hung it. All it was adultery, and fornication and sex bago marriage. The whole movie had nothing to do with love. There was no love in that whole movie.
Why in the world are you going out, or why do you want to go out and, into the streets where it's dangerous? Or aren't you afraid people are going to attack you, and nobody's going to listen anyhow, they'll say, and, you know, aren't you supposed to be teaching in the church, and, all the great men of God, like Charles Spurgeon and John Wesley and George Whitfield,
Their congregations were outside. They reached more people in the streets than they ever reached inside of a building. And I'll tell you, for 11 years I've been going out. And I'll tell you, I can reach a whole lot more people at a busy intersection with a sign like this than some people will preach to in their whole life inside of churches. I mean,
listen! Jesus, the Philippines might call the island pop. America might call the island, but we're losing it. And you're going to lose your freedom too if you don't use it properly. My 64 countries. Walang kalayaan para sa iyo, para sa like you. May kalayaan sa Vietnam, Carl? May kalayaan sa Vietnam? Yes or no? No! May kalayaan sa Cambodia? No! May kalayaan sa Saudi Arabia? Do you? May kalayaan sa Saudi Arabia? Yes or no? May kalayaan sa Saudi Arabia? No! May kalayaan sa Laos? No! May kalayaan sa Burma? Myanmar? No! May kalayaan sa Indonesia? No! May kalayaan sa Oman, United Arab Emirates, Kuwait? No! May kalayaan sa China? May kalayaan sa Mongolia? May kalayaan sa Nepal? No! 64 countries! Walang kalayaan! You cannot say what you want, you can't read the Bible, you can't speak about the Tohana. Pow wow, Hindi ganyan. Hindi pwede ganyan. Like ito, sa doon, pangalugar. Sayang. Ngunit dito sa Philippines, may kalayaan. You better watch it, friends. Ang yung kalayaan ay hindi para sa basura, like ito. Ang yung kalayaan ay hindi para sa ito. Ang yung kalayaan ay hindi para sa maging lasing tuwing Viernes ng gabi, you know? Ang yung kalayaan ay hindi para sa ang mga ito. Ang yung kalayaan ay hindi para sa ang mga ito. Ang yung kalayaan ay hindi para sa maraming mga discos, mas marami kaysa mga simbahan. People, hindi alam ang lahat ng katotohanan. They don't know Jesus. They will be pinakaanak, they will buhay, and they will patay. And hindi nakinig si Jesus on isang basis. Never one. 2.8 half that kalahate of buong sanlibutan. Kalahate of buong sanlibutan have never heard of Jesus Christ, have never heard ang magandang balita, have never heard ang katotohanan, have never heard that si Jesus ang daan, ang katotohanan, ang buhay, have never heard that ay isa ang Diyos, at isa ang tagapamagitan sa Diyos at sa mga tao. They've never heard one. And what are you doing about it? Voila! Nothing. Come on, friends! Babalik sa yung unang araw. Get back to the basics. Jesus said, if you're my disciple, follow me. Jesus says, if you love me, obey my commandments. Jesus says, sabi niya, humayo kayo sa lahat ng sanibutan at mag-preach ang magandang balita sa lahat ng mga tao. And I challenge you, if you want your nation to prosper, you better take the truth that you know and take it into all the world. Otherwise, you're in big trouble. Sino dito alam that God loves you? Sino dito alam that God loves you? Who knows that God loves you? Raise your hand kung alam mo that God loves you. Who knows that? Raise your hand. Okay, now listen. If you know that God loves you, let me put it this way. The real question is not, does God love you? The real question is, do you love God? If you love God, you will obey Him. Because love means obedience. You cannot have love and disobedience. Love must have obedience, kasama-sama. Love and obedience are the same.
Often I'll get hecklers. You know what a heckler is? A heckler is someone in a crowd that, wah, 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 or they laugh, or they say funny things. And, you know, hecklers are really a blessing from God because they're often used to draw a bigger crowd. I remember once when I was in Japan, I had a heckler that kept taking dirt and throwing it in the air on top of his head, you know, mocking me. And as a result, about 6 or 7 or 8 more people came and joined the crowd and listened intently. And so hecklers are nothing more than noisemakers, and they usually help to advance the crowd and get the word of God out to a lot more people.
But you hang on to it. So, hickpit, it's the same thing. No. Huh? He says no. I give you 10% of my time. Jesus didn't say give 10%. He said give generously. 10% is the bare minimum. The commandment of God is not to give 10% love, but it's to give generously. He that soweth generously shall reap generously. He said if the commandment is generous, not just 10%, but all of your heart, all of your soul, all of your mind, all of your strength, all of your family, all of your material possessions, everything you have, you are to give to God for His glory. You have what? Can I ask you? Oh, please, ask me a question. You know, I surrender this one, all right? But until now, I cannot speak. You know why? Yes. Tell me why. Do you know why? If you don't, I'll tell you. Why? Yeah. Why can you not quit?
Because in this cigarette, Jesus gave me the strength to make me sissy.
No.
Why?
But sissy is not Jesus' responsibility. Why? It's our responsibility.
No.
Repentance is a choice that we make.
Yes.
It has nothing to do with Jesus.
Yes.
Sin is a choice, and yes. Matsisi is a choice also.
Yes.
You haven't been freed because you have never learned to hate sin. You've never seen
it. Sure? That I hate sin?
You love sin.
Yes.
That's right. You
yes.
love sin. You
How
love
about
sin.
Demons?
Huh?
How about demons? Demons say they have no sins.
Demons have a lot of sin.
No.
They rebel against God.
Give
and
me
Jesus.
An example about demons who get the sins.
Okay. Demons sinned when they rebelled against God
no.
in the beginning with
no.
the sin of demons is rebellion.
No. How come?
Because they love themselves more than Jesus.
No.
Demons are rebellious angels, sir. Yes. Demons are rebellious angels. There's two types of angels.
Yes.
There's angels that obey God, and there's angels that hate God.
Where in the Bible the demons have a sin? In the Bible.
Okay.
Yes.
Isaiah.
Where in Isaiah?
I forgot the Isaiah.
I can get the where in Isaiah.
I can't.
Chapter and numbers.
I don't have it memorized. I'm sorry.
Oh.
But
how come are you teaching us?
Well.
Where is in Isaiah?
Do you have a Bible at home?
I don't have any Bible.
I believe it. I believe it. And if you did, you wouldn't read it anyhow. There's two types
sure
of angels.
That I will not read the Bible. In John 3:16.
Yeah.
For God so loved the world, He gave His only begotten Son.
Oh, good.
Where is in the Bible that demons
Isaiah. Isaiah and Genesis.
Maybe that.
No, that's
true.
There are two. Incommunicators. Demons.
No.
Have a
lot
of
I'm just asking.
He's not in the Bible.
I'm just
there
asking.
Are angels that love God.
Demons
and angels that hate God. And the type of angels that hate God are called demonic spirits. And demonic spirits have control over people that love sin. Demons.
Where in the Bible that demons have sin?
I told you. Isaiah and Genesis, but I don't remember the chapter. You'll have to look it up. I'm sorry.
I will give you the example.
Okay, what?
In John, that demons got Jesus.
For sure. Yes? Okay. You show me while you're doing
it. Yes, yes, yes. That they must have a seat.
Okay, show Jesus. Me. You show me and we'll all be happy that
yes,
this
yes.
Cigarette smoker knows
yes,
the Bible.
Yes.
Very good. Listen, demons have only as much control over your life as you give them. Hey, there's no demon that has control over my life because I hate sin. Now many of you, if you love sin, demons love you.
Are you
sure? Yeah. Obey God. It's
yes.
Very madalisi
yes. Yes.
If you love God, obey Him. That means if God says, "Ang yung katawan ay templo ng Holy Espiritu," and you say, if God says your body is a temple of God, and you say, "Who cares? Bahala, gusto ko ito," then you're not loving God. You're loving yourself.
Yes.
And the Bible says, if you love yourself more than God, you're not worthy of me. Dapat magsisi kayo at magbalik loob sa Diyos. May pag-asa pa para sa'yo. May bagong buhay para sa'yo. I used to smoke, sir. I used to be a smoker.
This may help me quit my smoking and also my drinking.
Magsisi.
How come? How?
Stop sinning. Stop it.
Oh,
take your cigarettes and go like this and never touch them again.
No, it's my cigarette.
Okay, good. Don't ever pick it up again. Don't ever buy another one. And that will show that you truly repented and you truly love God. Just like me.
No, is listen, that you?
Listen, before, when I was Hindi Cristiano, I used to call Manami rock and roll. I loved the Bee Gees. I loved Nirvana. Before, ang aking favoritong Elvis Presley, ganyan, Beatles, AC/DC, ganyan. But when I became a Christian, 1984, I took all of my rock and roll albums and I smashed them and threw them sa basurahan. That's magsisi. That's repentance. And if you love God, you'll take your cigarettes and you'll go like this. You'll take your mga, you'll take your mga, San Miguel, and you'll smash and say, "Ayoko, no more." You'll take your, absolutely. You will take your Barocco magazine and you'll tear it up, or you'll take it apuwi and you'll burn it and say, "No more, Lord. Ang aking puso para sa'yo, ang aking buhay para sa'yo." You'll repent and you'll sumunod sa kanya and you'll stay in ang tuwid ng buhay. Mga kaibigan, pumasok kayo sa makipot na pintuan. Sapagkat maluwang ang pintuan at malapad ang daan patungo sa kapahamakan at marami talaga ay nasa sasongkong ngayon. Pumasok ang makipot ng pintuan. Kunti lang kami. There's just a few. But it's the right choice. It's the right way. Choose Jesus, friends. Follow Jesus. Not just simbahan na lang. It's kulang. Simbahan na lang is kulang. Boys, there's not enough power there. You've got to obey Jesus. You've got to say, "Jesus, here I am. Anong dapat gagawin ko para sa'yo? What should I do? Anong aking basura sa aking puso? What can I give you more, Lord?" If you don't give all of your heart, you will lose and lose and lose and lose, and the devil will get the victory. It has to be everything or nothing at all. Mm-hmm.